Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Nico.
And I'm Luisa.
We are here to interview Marc Macai, a 25-year-old Romanian filmmaker and director of the short film Jackpot, selected for the international competition here at Kafoskari Short Film Festival. First question, Marc, the most difficult one. How are you?
Hello, guys. Nice to meet you. I'm very, very I'm so glad being here. This is a very good place. This is a very good city. This is my first time in Venice, and I was so honored when I thought about the selection of the movie, and I decided that this is the time, the first time I will visit Venice. So I'm very good. This is a very good day. This is a very good condition and weather and everything is good.
Very good. We're very glad to hear that, and we are hoping to see you again. Another question. What were the pros and cons of being both the director and one of the actors of the short film? Is the screenwriting also by you, or is it a co-production with other colleagues of yours?
So, first of all, I will start with the screenwriting part. I was the only one who dreamed about this story. I wrote it down like many times. Like it passed like a half a year before it took the final form of the screenplay. There was a lot of versions, a lot of plus characters, minus characters or something. But that was a story I wanted to tell and wanted to show and wanted to see on the screen. So that's how it started. You know, there's a character, Pablo, whose actor is, it's me. I thought that in the first impression that it will be more easier because you don't need another actor, you don't need to talk him, you don't need to talk to another actor or give instructions. So I thought in the first place that it will be easier playing me in my screenplay, in my movie, but that was the hardest part because I knew every character's intention. I wrote it down, every character's very, how do I say, detailed. But I forget it about the Pablo's character because it was me. I didn't want to give instructions for me. Then I was like, why I need to write that? I will know on the set. So and before the shooting day, all night I just stand in my room and thinking about how do I imagine this character? How do I play? How will I play this character? So it was pretty difficult. The pros was just to, you know, you don't have to pay for another actor, you don't have to pay food for another. So for the budget, it was very good. And you don't have to choose the right time to shoot with this actor because the director is there, you know? And the cons were those stuff that when was my scene, I didn't see the picture, I didn't see the composition. As a director, you have to see all of these things. How do I look on the screen? And it took a lot of more time because I wanted to see one more time. But I had a very good friend there on set. He's also a director and he helped me about the other directing stuff when I was on screen.
Perfect. It's very impressive of you to have been both the director, an actor, and even the screenwriter.
Thank you.
Okay, then, your short film is a mix of thriller and comedy, fiction, reality, grotesque, and tragic. What was it like to juggle such concentrating genres and approaches, and as the usage of flat character helped you in this?
So this part of the film was the choosing the genre of the film, because I wanted to make like a more commerce style movie, just to catch up with the audience, just to catch the audience with those things, and I was bored being stick to just one genre, and I wanted to mix it them, and it was a very good exercise for me too as a director, as a writer, to combine those genres, to combine those characters, those filming styles or something. And what was the other part of the question?
If the usage of flat character helped you in this?
Like
flat character is the one who don't change in their intention, behavior from the beginning.
Yes.
On them.
Yes. The main character was like really a flat character, that without any character development, and this is what is the film about. Like some people can't change even with the best impression of them. They can't even change. Like I think the most important part of this film, it's about that people will play until they will lose. So like with the gambling stuff, they won't stop at one winning, they will play until they lose. So that was the impersonation of this character. Those ideas was the main character's role.
Thank you. Besides the gambling addiction theme, you have also discussed other delicate themes like veganism and disabilities, and also the cross-cultural relations between different gangs, because we can see during the film that there are three spoken languages, and the type of language that is spoken implies a different position in the power structure of the gangs. What were your intention using these different themes? What were you trying to portray? Why have you chosen these three themes specifically?
So I just wanted to portray the whole Transylvanian lifestyle. Like how we as Transylvanians, as Romanians, how do we meet and how do we react to those things like veganism, like who loves the ketchup or the mustard better, and the like stuff, and that was the main story that we as Transylvanians, like you know, in those Balkanic gangs, they are like this. So I made a lot of friends a few more years ago who was like Balkanic gangsters or something, and I had a lot of inspiration for those guys, for those people, and I just wanted to portray them as they are like this is nothing of fiction, just kind of parody, I think. And this is the most parodistic part for me, like we don't struggle with those things like the north, like the western part of the world, like in America, with those pride stuff, with those LGBT stuff, and those, we don't care about this. We are just living with this, and with the multicultural stuff. Like I have my native language is Hungarian, and I have a lot of Romanian friends who also know Hungarian language, but they can speak. And when I was a child, I couldn't speak perfectly Romanian, so we talked each other, like I talked on my native language in Hungarian. He understood all of this. He replied to me in Romanian, and we just spoke like that. We just communicate like that, and that was the parodistic part, like the Polish guy. Like, of course, we don't have a Polish guy speaking Polish in Romania, and we understand it. It was just a hyperbolical like a parodistic part of we can understand everyone. I think this is the best this is the best part to describe this word.
Thank you. Then there's a personal question of mine. All characters are very two-dimensional. They're even always dressed the same throughout the short film, except for Manu, that is always dressed the same, but not in the scene where he meets the Polish guy. Then he's dressed exactly like Pablo. Was it intentional? And why did you take this decision?
This is the first time like someone noticed this small touch, because it was intentional. Like the main intention was like Manu starts to tell a completely fictional story to this bartender girl, but Manu knows that that she will listen to him if Manu will portray him as Pablo. So in the first cutscene, he looks like Pablo because he wants to catch up the girl's attention. And after he notices that she will listen to him, he can't say anything, she will listen to him because of Pablo, he will portray themselves like in the real life. So it was just to catch up the girl's attention in the first impression with Pablo portrayal.
Perfect. Thank you, Mark, for answering our questions and dedicating us some of your time. We'd like to remind you that Jackpot is competing in the Kapowskoj Short Film Festival in the international competition. So good luck with that, Mark, and for all your future works.
Thank you very much. Thank you,
guys. Wishing you the best.